Hello folks, Chuck here again, Hillbilly Half Acre Homestead. Hope everyone is doing well on this August afternoon. Was in this hive late yesterday evening and I noticed that they are just on the verge of having all these frames filled out. And I noticed that they were starting to draw some drone comb. And many times that's an indicator that within a couple or 3 weeks, they're gonna swarm if you don't do something about it. So what I'm gonna do here today is I'm gonna give these guys another box. I've got another 8-frame deep box down here. And between the top and the bottom, we're gonna checkerboard some frames. Now, when I do this, I'm gonna try to move the ones that are primarily nectar and honey into the box that I'm gonna have on the top. And I'm gonna try to keep the brood, the ones that are primarily brood, I'm gonna try to keep them located in the bottom box. Ideally, that way, you know, I think that's the way the bees would prefer to have it anyway, and that way they won't have to move so much honey around. Because anytime you do this, you're always gonna do something that the bees aren't gonna like, and they're gonna start moving stuff around after you make changes. So, the more you follow their natural tendencies, the less you're gonna set them back, I think, when you do this stuff. I'm new at this, so don't quote me on that. All right, to start out, I'm gonna be kind of mixing these in. For those of you who don't know what checkerboarding is, you're just taking some full frames and alternating them with empty frames, okay? So, got my trusty hive tool here. We're gonna go in the hive here. I smoked them at the entrance. I guess I could lay a little smoke here across the top of the box. This hive is usually pretty good natured.
The wind feels good.
This one next to it, different story.
Is that the one that got stung you in the ear?
I don't know. Them bees don't hold signs when they fly by and sting you in the ear that says what hive they came from.
Wow.
Okay, look at that big old, that's first frame out of the box, see there? That's almost completely covered in cap brood. I'll make these bees move around. See, now some of it's starting to emerge already. See the little openings? That's bees that's already emerged. So that we got some new little honeybees running around in here. But see that pattern? This queen is doing very well. That laying pattern goes all the way, covers practically the entire frame. So I'm gonna set this frame right here for now, because that's gonna need to go back into the bottom box, okay? So what I'm gonna do right now is I'm gonna keep going here and see if I can find out where they're putting their nectar. That just tells you how bad they needed another box when you've got brood right there on the side frame. Because usually that's where they, on a single box hive like that, they prefer to have their nectar against the wall. Or at least that's what I've seen, I've noticed. Nice big old fat, thick frame of bees. It's completely covered. And I'm just gonna slide this one over and put it back in. What I need to do, I guess, first is I'm gonna kinda go across this box here and I'm gonna look and see what I have got in here, okay? So, now here's one they're just working on filling out, but, you know, they've added 2 inches to this since yesterday, probably overnight, lengthwise here. This was about here last night when I checked it. So, they've been busy overnight. Doesn't look like they're really working on drawing it down at the moment, though. Oh, they're starting another lobe up here, I think is what's going on. Anyway, that comb has got, looks like no brood. Okay, this is all honey, even though there's not much there. They're gonna continue to work on that, so I'm gonna move that frame into this box. Okay, and I'm gonna put that right there on the side, okay? And then what I'm doing here is I'm gonna put an empty one put an empty one right there next to it. Now I'm ready to put another frame with bees and wax into that box, or into that spot now. Okay, see what we got here. See what we have here. Okay, we've got bee bread. We've got bee bread and we've got honey. So we're gonna move this over here. Now they're gonna move a little bit of this probably back because they like to keep a little bee bread. Well, maybe they don't move the bee bread so much, but they like to keep a little of that nectar and what have you close to the brood. So we'll see what happens. Okay, so I put another frame in there, so now I move another empty over. Okay, so I've gotten four frames in this box. Okay, so I need two more frames out of here in that box. All right, here, pretty new white comb. It's all nectar, all honey. So I'm going to put that in here. All right. And I'm going to move that over. So I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 frames in there. All right. So I need one more. I'll tell you what, I'm going to have to. Oh, I didn't think about laying that in the sun. Sitting it right in the sun like I did. See, it's not completely attached across the bottom and it's trying to fall in on me. Come on, ladies, move out of the way. That'll help it, that little, give it a little bit of support. I'm only going to be a few minutes here yet. We'll see what's going on and move one more frame. That one will go back in here with some empty frames. Okay. I've got a little bit of brood on this frame, open and, but I've got honey. So I think just to entice these guys to maybe have the queen come up here and lay. By the way, I saw the queen last night. I'm not really taking the time to look for the queen in here today. Because I really don't care whether she ends up in the top box or the bottom box. These frames were all honey, so she could have been on one of those, but chances are likely that she would be on one that was a brood frame. So she could be in there, but anyway, it don't matter. They're all gonna go right back together, and she'll have full reign. I don't use a queen excluder. She'll have full reign of this box, and she can go anywhere in there she wants to and lay anywhere she wants to. And in my opinion, the more the better. So we got now 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Another empty. 8. Okay, got that? Cool. Now, to encourage these guys to draw out this frame, what I know, one thing that Chuck knows, is that they don't like, hive beetles. Watch. The only surefire way of killing them, I think. Okay, that's got a little honey in it, and that's okay. We'll checkerboard that, and you know what's going to happen? They're just going to move it, because I'm going to put this frame right here, I'm going to check it, but I think it's got brood on it. It does. Oh, okay, we've got honey, and we've got capped and open brood on this frame. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to put that frame right back there. Okay, so what I've got a frame here. All right, I've got a frame there. And I'm going to start putting in some empties in between. So right here, I've got a full frame that was originally in the box. Okay, I'm gonna clean, the bees will clean all this stuff off, but these have been up there in the shop, where sawdust and planter shavings and what have you goes everywhere, but the bees will clean that up. So here's what I've done. I put a full frame, then a new frame. Now this one was partially drawn and it's got honey on it, but see that being in the middle? That's going to entice them to go ahead and continue drawing that, but they're also going to move this honey probably up into one of those frames, because they don't really like it in the middle of the brood nest, and that's going to end up being kind of in the middle of the brood nest. So I'm going to take this frame right here. It's got a little honey at the top of it, but it's also got open and capped brood. All right, so full, empty, full, empty, full. Now I put another empty in here. I try to knock off what I can. In an ideal world, I would have taken these up there and blown them off really good with compressed air. But the bees know how to take care of it.
There's a fight going on right here.
It's the only thing I can think of. Got one trying to rob. Where?
Mm-hmm.
Way over there?
Yeah, right here. There's two bees fighting.
Huh. Well, keep track of who wins.
Okay. They flew from that one up there.
Which, this first one?
Yeah.
Yeah. That's a weaker hive, so it wouldn't surprise me that they would try. That's how we checkerboard a hive, folks. And you do that. Now, there's bees in here that I moved with the frames, right?
Hey, look at that.
So what we do here, we take this box, and we just simply put it right up there. In its place, right on top of that. Get it swung around there. Uh-oh, that box is out of square. That's annoying. I'll have to double check that box. Rained last night, but
the one from the box right here hit one.
Did it?
Yeah.
Good.
That other one's dead right here.
Huh. Okay, ladies. Y'all get in the box there now. Don't have a bee brush, but my glove works pretty good. As long as they don't decide to fly up here and sting me on the bare part of my arm.
Or fly up your shorts leg.
I don't wear shorts working the bees.
Well, I did.
Yeah, nobody's perfect, son. That's just the way it goes. We live and learn. I didn't even have to get stung on the britches leg. Well, yeah, actually I did. That's why I started using
tape and duct tape.
Okay, that's how we checkerboard a beehive, folks. I hope this has helped somebody. If you have any questions, why, leave a comment in the or leave a question or something in the comments below. We appreciate it if you'd subscribe to our channel. We put videos like this, and we got quail videos, we got rabbit videos, chicken, ducks, everything, as well as the bee videos. So we got a little something for everybody at some point in time. So if you could, or if you would like, subscribe to the channel. You get a notification that way whenever we put up a new video. Anyway, just y'all have a good day, and God bless.